I'm 16, and I pray that I don't pray for myself too much. It's just becoming a big boy is learning that letting people in will start feeling like drafting bodies to a war your body didn't fully declare. It is finding and losing yourself and other people at the same time. It is finishing sentences with footsteps and retracing them back when you need closure the most. You see, part of becoming a big boy is realizing that silence makes everything so much easier. Is realizing that silence has the quivering ability of being able to suck and supply the poison from a room. When I was 13, I learned that tear-soaked journal paper makes for polite conversations with girls. When I was 14, I started what they call smelling myself. At 15, I taught myself how to cry myself to sleep and still wake up afloat. You see, part of maturing is learning who not to break around. Is learning that tears just make the battleground muddier. The salt in the tears will only make the wounds sting more, so don't you dare cry. Just mask it, like a clown. Better yet, be one. Be colorful, make them laugh while your insides darken. Wouldn't want them to know that you're hurting, so just lie. Tell them you only cried because you want to. Tell them sticks and stones ain't nothing, but words still hit you like ricochet bullets off of a funny mirror. Tell them you don't cry until all the lights are off and you let the jazz notes carry you. Tell them you know how much pain can come from sleeping with everybody else's secrets and nobody will sleep on yours. Tell them becoming a big boy hurts, but you love it. Tell them big boys don't know when to say no to sympathy and don't hesitate. Tell them becoming a big boy burns like 53 fireflies giving birth inside you at once. You see, this is what being a big boy is about. Telling yourself all these things just to keep burning. I mean going. I mean every word. So just hush. And just be still.